Like, you guys, find out how many there is.
3500. You guys all agree that Nikola Tesla was a great scientist?
Oh, he was a genius. For sure, right? He was a genius, but you got to remember that Nikola Tesla lived in a world where he was so far ahead of the curve, and there's very few people that were able to compete with him or even understand what he was doing.
Do you know that if you go to YouTube and you punch in Nikola Tesla hoax fraud, nothing comes up?
That's amazing. Makes sense, but that's also a guy who lived in the 1920s.
There's not anybody on the planet trying to say all that shit was bullshit. There's no, you go to YouTube, punch in Nikola Tesla, hoax, fraud, not one fucking video. There's videos that come up that saying something else was a hoax, Nikola Tesla proves it, or you know, Nikola Tesla proves hoax, but not one video of anybody ever saying Nikola Tesla was
like,
hoax.
I feel like
but,
a guy like that.
But, this is just a fact. You can take it or leave it. Put in Albert Einstein hoax fraud. Endless videos.
Albert was a freak.
Yeah. Endless videos. And like, wait a minute. Wasn't Albert Einstein Time Magazine's Man of the Century?
Okay, but let me
How
stop.
Is that even possible? I thought he was the smartest man in the world. Hold on a second.
Let me just help you here. You're getting very dramatic. So let me stop for a second. If you put in Holocaust hoax, you'll get an equal number.
I'm not talking about that.
But you
I'm
know
talking
that's
about,
true. If you put in Sandy Hook hoax, you're getting an equal number. You get a tremendous number of people to think that
Nikola Tesla.
It's amazing. What? Well, also,
why not him?
How about people that don't think that Richard Pryor was a genius?
Have
you ever met a comic once that doesn't think Richard Pryor is one of the greatest of all time? They don't exist.
But are there videos of people trying to prove that he wasn't the greatest?
No, but I mean, look,
no.
I believe that
he was a hoax.
That,
no. There's nothing on Nikola Tesla.
I don't think that Einstein was a hoax, dude. I
correlation
mean,
is not the
you know
same
what?
As causation, you, though, Eddie.
Shit.
You know?
I'm not, I don't know nothing. All I know is there's nothing on Nikola Tesla. No
but it doesn't
hoaxes,
mean anything.
But there's thousands of Albert Einstein. You look into his life, like, oh,
but is there
shit.
Anyone besides
you
Nikola Tesla
him,
that
oh,
doesn't have
shit.
That? Is he the only guy, Eddie?
Well, Thomas Edison was always accused of stealing the ideas of Nikola Tesla. In fact, Thomas Edison electrocuted an elephant in the middle of, like, what was it, the World Science
Thomas
Fair?
Thomas Edison did?
Yes,
I mean,
he
Thomas,
did.
Oh, Thomas Edison. I thought you said Thomas Jefferson.
No,
sorry.
Thomas Edison electrocuted a fucking elephant.
There's video of it.
Because he wanted to prove that alternating and direct current, like AC/DC, which was Tesla's
that?
Idea.
There's video of an elephant being current. Electrocuted, not by Thomas
How
Edison.
But
no, but Thomas Edison did it. Jeez. The reason why he did it is to prove God or to try damn. To, like, it was propaganda against Tesla's ideas, which are more advanced.
And
there's
an open form,
a movable, like, he wanted there to be alternating currents. And
Tesla
Edison was a direct
and Einstein were alive and kicking at the same time. Tesla, there's quotes. The quotes could be bullshit.
Well, you know,
but
Tesla
there's quotes
comes
of the Tesla's
several decades
crushing
before
Einstein,
Einstein
clowning him in
Wasn't
public.
He
thought Einstein was a fraud. That could be a fr- that
well,
could be
I've heard,
that
I've
could
heard
be
that
bullshit. But there are quotes that can be bullshit of no, Tesla. There's I keep they keep
I
th- popping up.
Eddie,
Tesla
think,
breaking.
Eddie,
no. Hold on.
Yeah.
Hold on. There's quotes. Yeah. Tesla quotes saying the theory of relativity is basically a joke. There's Tesla
no, no,
quotes
but Eddie,
of that.
Eddie, hold on.
No. What I'm saying is it could be bullshit, but it keeps coming up.
Well, no. We know that the theory of relativity is used, right? So that we know that that's not so much a theory anymore. But here's what I think that he's addressing. So Einstein, from what I have read, is Einstein was a great mind, but he was coming up at a time where he got most of the credit. He became a famous scientist mm-hmm. when there were a lot of scientists working on very similar ideas.
He was an average scientist who got blown up.
And contributing to the larger mm-hmm. debate about quantum physics, right?
So you know, there was also a big debate about their methods, whereas Tesla was a big fan of experiments. Einstein was a big fan of equations, and one of the big criticisms, what does it say? What is this? Tesla's overrated, debunking the cult of Tesla. Tesla's a popular figure in conspiracy culture. What is it saying?
What is he saying? Tesla.
He says Tesla
is not even just a conspiracy thing. What is he saying?
He's saying Tesla's
not
real.
Genius?
He said right here, he says Tesla was a popular figure today, but he's also a self-publicist, and this is the stuff he didn't invent.
He did not invent alternating current?
Yeah.
He just was one of many people working on it? Okay, but he's probably one of the forefront minds, right? Being a showman, helped popularize its use. He's so good at that, eventually had to... I don't know if he's right or not.
Dude, he's shitting on Tesla. I just mean there's no
one
ever.
Eddie said there's no one saying anything against him, but there is.
But Mick West is always against... He's 100% official story. He's not against... He doesn't believe in that one conspiracy
theory. No, you're right, 100%. And that's one of my... The only criticism I had about that guy. Like, when we talked about the Gulf of Tonkin, he doesn't want to even admit that the Gulf of Tonkin was a false flag.
Tower 7's obvious.
Also, Operation Northwoods, he was trying to downplay. I'm like, look, man, whether or not you know what happened in any other place, like, you know the Joint Chiefs of Staff wrote down a memo saying that what the plan was to have Guantanamo Bay attacked by Cuban friendlies that were going to give them guns, give them bombs, have them attack American civilians.
What did he say?
He was like, well, it never was like implemented. I was like, it doesn't matter. They signed it. Kennedy had a veto. Yes, but Kennedy vetoed it. That's why those checks and balances are in place. Like, no. The mindset behind the type of person that would want to blow up Americans and blame it on the Cubans so we could justify
the founding
a war
fathers
with
knew
Cuba.
That, though. The founding fathers knew that there would always be people within the government that
You're
would do anything they could. And so that's where the checks and balances, of course.
But they don't always go through.